IBM for sponsoring this video. So before the cloud, most software companies hosted their own infrastructure. And what that means is they bought their own computers, rented a warehouse, and used them to run their code 24/7. So their products, their software applications, were always available for their customers. Now, the introduction of the cloud really has to do with who manages these computers, or as they're often called, servers, since they're serving code to customers. Previously, it was entirely the responsibility of the software company. The company had to buy the computers with the right specs of what they'll think they'll need. They had to upgrade the computers and keep the hardware up to date. They also had to make sure their app stayed up and running on every single computer, and there wasn't some fire in some warehouse. While you might think that's easy, oh, let me just go buy some computers, it's actually quite complicated. For example, if there's a local network outage, your servers might be affected, and your application, your product, would go down and become unavailable. This means you'll probably have multiple warehouses with lots of computers, and it would get very complicated. In fact, most of the time, these companies will hire internal support teams to manage these servers, making the cost of this go higher and higher. Now, if you're just a startup that's trying to host code on the internet, this is unfeasible. A startup wants to focus on their app, not the infrastructure of their application, and the same is true at larger companies. This is what brought about the cloud. The cloud is basically another company managing the computers that run your code, and they make it available to customers. It's a cloud of computers. Instead of having to buy each computer with a set spec, you simply rent a computer with the specs of your choice, and you can change what computer you rent at any time. You don't have to update the hardware. You don't have to rent the warehouse. You just rent the machine you want to run your code on, and a cloud provider manages the rest. Some cloud providers include IBM Cloud, Google Cloud Platform, and Azure. Amazon Web Services is also a cloud provider, but it was made before we called the cloud, which is probably why it's not in the name. So these companies started with on-premise infrastructure, their own computers that they managed in their own warehouses, and then moved their applications to the cloud using cloud providers. They moved their applications to servers managed by another company. This helped them reduce infrastructure costs and ensure that their application was more highly available. It also allowed the companies to be more flexible in their infrastructure. They could scale up during peak traffic and then scale back down, only using the infrastructure or servers they need at the moment. But this introduces a new problem. How exactly do you configure these machines? Although you can rent them, you still need to know what resources and specifications you need at a given time. How do you make sure you're not wasting money on unnecessary infrastructure? Well, you could stare at dashboards for hours and hours on end, and then eventually make an educated guess, or you could use a tool from our sponsor, Turbonomic from IBM. Turbonomic is a cloud optimization tool that ensures applications always perform at their lowest possible cost. It automates changing your cloud configurations to meet application demand. Turbonomic can also determine the correct machine spec for your application, resize your containers, and it supports any upstream version of Kubernetes. Now, you might think that determining these resource configurations is easy, but even for a simple application, there are thousands of possible configurations, and they can change over time depending on how much traffic you're getting. For example, one way you can scale your app is horizontally. This happens when we add more computers to help compute data or serve the traffic coming to our application. However, this only works if those extra computers are actually needed. Otherwise, these servers might become underutilized or even unused, accruing cost unnecessarily. There's also vertical scaling. Instead of adding more computers, We make each computer more powerful with a better CPU or increased storage. You can also scale down, making each computer less powerful with a slower CPU or less storage. Picking the right type of computer to run your application is tricky because there are so many combinations of memory, processor, storage, and network configurations. It's tough to know what's best for your application, and what's best can change over time. So the cloud didn't solve every problem. In fact, it created new ones, and this is typical of any new advancement or invention in technology. All right, that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you Turbonomic from IBM for sponsoring. In the next video, I'll show you how to automate the scaling of your infrastructure using Turbonomic. I'll see you next time, and happy coding.